the first female doctor in Montana. When Elizabeth was a child, she lived in a very crowded house. At one time, Elizabeth had four siblings. There was a two-tailed frog in New York City. When Elizabeth had to go up against herself during the Civil War, she organized donation collection and supplies for the Union and men in the war and the Union service. She would collect books, blankets, socks, and other things. When Elizabeth was an adult, she was friends with Florence Nightingale, a very famous nurse and also a post for female nurses, even nurses back then. Elizabeth was 11 years old. Her family was in debt and decided to sell all over again by moving from England to America, a whole new world for women. I chose this quote because you can use this quote in so many different ways. A life lesson, for example. It is so true. You don't know what you are capable of. Elizabeth died of a stroke in Hastings, England. The newspaper wrote, she was in the fullest world a pioneer, like all pioneers, when this village heard the development. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I chose Elizabeth Blackwell because I thought that she was a small and intelligent girl and brought from London.
What was the start of you liking Elizabeth?
Well, I read a book about J.K. Moody, and she was dressing up as Elizabeth Blackwell because she wanted to be a doctor, so I got inspired because I thought Elizabeth Blackwell was in that she that it was very cool that she was the first female doctor in the world. Okay.
You go on your own then?
I think like when she was like, I don't know when her dad died, but she was very young and she was very sad because of that.